Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the various BGP attribute categories. Border Gateway Protocol, or BGP, is a path vector routing protocol used on the internet, as well as on some large enterprise networks. When BGP has two or more possible paths to a particular destination, it examines a series of attributes of each of those paths to determine which is the best one. Now, these attributes are categorized into four main groups that define how the attributes are handled and processed by the BGP best path algorithm. These categories are well-known mandatory, well-known discretionary, optional transitive, and optional non-transitive. Let's dig deeper into what each of these categories means. Let's start off by looking at the well-known mandatory attributes first. What does this title mean? Well-known simply means that the attribute must be recognized and understood by all BGP implementations, regardless of the vendor or version of the BGP software. This ensures a consistent understanding and behavior across all the different types of BGP routers that may exist in a network. The term mandatory means that the attribute must appear in every BGP update that's sent. If a well-known mandatory attribute isn't contained within a BGP update, that update is considered corrupt and will not be processed. It'll simply be dropped. Examples of well-known mandatory attributes include the AS path, which is simply a list of ASs that must be traversed to reach a particular destination. If a BGP message tells us about a particular network and there's no AS path in the BGP update, the message is dropped. Another example is the next hop IP. This indicates the IP address of the next hop. If that's not found within the BGP update, the message is dropped. If we take a look at this topology here, if we have R1 sending a BGP update to R2, and that BGP update does not include any AS path or is missing the next hop IP, R2 will simply drop that BGP update. Next, we have the well-known discretionary attributes. Now, like the previous category, the term well-known simply means that the attribute is universally understood by all BGP implementations. However, the term discretionary here means that this attribute is not required to appear in every BGP update message. Local preference is an example of a well-known discretionary attribute. Now, an interesting thing to note here is that if you're comparing two BGP routes based on a well-known discretionary attribute, and one route doesn't have that attribute, the decision process doesn't automatically favor the route with or without the attribute. What will actually happen depends upon the particular attribute in question. In some cases, the route with the attribute set is preferred over the one that's not set. In other cases, such a scenario would be considered a tie and they would go on to the next BGP attribute to resolve the issue. So you'll have to look at the particular discretionary attribute in question to know what actually happens in each case. On to the optional transitive attributes. Now, the word optional here means that these attributes are not required to be recognized by all BGP implementations. If a BGP router doesn't recognize an optional transitive attribute, it should mark the attribute and then pass it on to other BGP peers. It doesn't drop the BGP message. This ensures that the attribute is propagated even if some routers in the path don't understand it. And that's what the word transitive means here. Now, an example of an optional transitive attribute is a BGP community. A community may or may not be included in the BGP updates, and if they are, they must be passed on to other BGP routers, even if the router itself is not configured to process that particular community. So in our example here, if R1 sends an update to R2 with a particular community set, if R2 is not configured to participate in that particular community, it can ignore that attribute. But it is obligated to forward that on to R3 or to any other BGP peers that it may be connected to. Finally, we've come to our optional non-transitive attributes. Now again, optional simply means that these attributes are not required to be recognized by all BGP implementations. However, the non-transitive aspect means that if a router doesn't recognize the attribute, it will discard it and it won't pass it on to other BGP peers. An example of such an attribute is the multi-exit discriminator, or MED. This attribute suggests the preferred path to external neighbors when multiple paths exist to reach the same destination. It's used to influence the path selection in a way that doesn't affect other ASs. Now, one more thing to note here is that well-known attributes, by their very nature, must be transitive. This means that they must necessarily be shared between BGP peers. Now, as is the case with discretionary attributes, if you're comparing two BGP routes based on an optional attribute and one route doesn't have an attribute, the decision process again doesn't automatically favor the route with or without the attribute. The behavior when comparing routes based on an optional attribute is not universally consistent across all optional attributes, and it depends on the particular attribute in question. Also, we can see in the BGP RFC, it describes each attribute in detail, and it states whether those attributes are mandatory, discretionary, optional, transitive, or non-transitive. And you can see that here in this excerpt from the BGP RFC. You can find a link to this official RFC definition of BGP in the description below. Well, as always, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other topics related to BGP, feel free to let me know in the comments, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.